What's up guys, by popular demand I now present the Quill Rain Cast on Crit Spog and Ethereal Knives Belt Guide. You can play this build in both softcore and hardcore. The belt deals insane amounts of damage and it is somewhat cheap to get going, but once you reach endgame there are certain somewhat expensive or mildly expensive mandatory items you're going to need if you want to survive the highest level maps. Besides that, there are a few necessary unique leveling items that you will need as well, including a tabula rasa and an uncle's harmony. For defenses, this build makes use of a high amount of life and evasion, the acrobatics and face acrobatics keystone, and as weird as it sounds, a very reliable and very effective knockback effect, making it hard for even bosses to reach your character. And when it comes to reflect damage, I haven't had any issues so far, even without Volpact. You will take a bit of damage when attacking a reflect mob, and I'm sure that if you go full retard that you can eventually kill yourself. That said, you guys know it, you never go full retard. So if you play responsibly and use a basalt and topaz flask to mitigate incoming physical and lightning damage, then you should be completely fine. At least I have been so far, and my character is level 87 or something like that. Your main damage setup consists of barrage, cast on crit, ethereal knives, spark, pierce, and increased critical strike chains. With this setup, you will, every time you crit with barrage, have a chance of your cast on crit gem proccing the linked spells Ethereal Knives and Spark. These spells are then supported by pierce and increased critical strike chains, as both of these support gems greatly increase the damage and the chance of further proccing cast on crits. To generate frenzy charges and apply your curse, you will need frenzy, curse on hit, assassin's mark, and greater multiple projectiles. So with this setup, you will be attacking with frenzy, getting a frenzy charge, and you will be applying curse on hit every time you use this attack. For better mobility and more damage, you will need blink arrow linked with anger, herald of ice, and life leech. With this, herald of ice will leech life for you every time it shatters and deals damage with its explosion, and while it isn't necessary at all, it is a nice quality of life addition that keeps your health full most of the time, or at least helps regen some life. To further improve your defenses, I also recommend cast when damage taking link with Arctic Breath, greater multiple projectiles, and temporal chains. With this setup, you will, whenever you take a big hit, cast Arctic Breath and temporal chains at the enemies, thus making them much slower and you much safer. Finally, as an attempt to make you even more durable and to make your life a little easier, I recommend cast when damage taking Immortal Coal, increased duration, and Ice Golem. With this, you will, whenever you take a big chunk of damage, automatically cast Immortal Coal and become immune to physical damage for about half a second. This may not sound like much, but it makes a significant difference as it stops this heavy burst damage that almost resembles a one-shot from happening in Path of Exile sometimes, and thus making your character safe. Besides that, it also summons your Ice Golem for you, so you don't have to do this manually all the time yourself. And as always guys, make sure to check the forum guide as for my recommendations as how far to level cast when damage taken and its supported skill gems in the setups. So when it comes to leveling, here's a few tips I'd recommend you follow. First of all, for the first 50 levels, I recommend leveling up self-casting Orb of Storms and Spark using whatever support gems you prefer, and dual-wielding two Lifespring Wands for the extra damage. Secondly, make sure to pick up all the skill gems and supports as soon as you can and start leveling them, even though you won't be using them until level 50. By doing this, they won't be underleveled when you finally transition into cast on crit. Thirdly, once you reach level 50 and want to transition into cast on crit, I'd recommend you buy yourself a tabula rasa for your gem setup, an uncle's harmony as a temporary cheap solution to boosting your crit chains, and since you won't have enough base crit chains to use a quill ring yet, then you need to buy a rare high crit chains bow to help proc cast on crit. Once you've done that and made sure to incorporate the Assassin's Mark curse, then you can start trying to use the cast on crit setup. It may feel a little sluggish at start, but as you can see from the video, it really takes off as you progress. Finally, once you have picked up Deadly Infusion and can generate at least 5 power charges, I'd recommend switching over to Quill Rain. When you do this, your crit chance is going to drop slightly, but due to the base crit chance increase of Deadly Infusion, it should make up for it. If not, just keep using the high crit bow until it does. With the power charges and Quill Rain, you should aim for at least 70% crit chance before you start using it as your main weapon. As for the skill tree, make it your first priority to grab a bit of extra projectile speed and damage from Sniper.
then head down and pick up piercing shots. From here you simply want to travel towards the duelist start for extra projectile damage and life. At around level 40 I'd recommend you start picking up the various crit nodes so that you can be prepared for when you switch over to cast on crit around level 50. If you feel it's necessary you can also pick up lethality as a temporary crit boost early on in the game, however if you do this I'd recommend specking out of it later once your critical strike chance gem is higher level as these are somewhat inefficient compared to what else you can get. Somewhere around the time when you transition into cast on crit you should also spec into the acuity notable and get yourself the Volleyfire Jewel and place it here. In this skill tree this is the only place where you can reach 50 dexterity in a radius and thus benefiting from the extra projectiles you can now fire. To be able to sustain the mana cost of Barrage I'd recommend you spec into Essence Sap or buy yourself 2 jewels with at least 2 mana gained on hit and whatever other various stats you prefer. Alternatively you can also craft yourself and use 2 Elrion Rings but that's up to you. I find the Essence Sap method to be the most reliable. Finally, make sure to grab the power charges so that once you get Deadly Infusion as your 4th Ascendancy point, you can make full use of it. While doing all this, it is of course important that you pick up enough life nodes so that you can safely progress throughout the game. As always guys, if you are in doubt on how to spend your skill points, then make sure to check the leveling skill tree templates listed in the forum build guide for a more detailed step-for-step approach. The link is in the description of the video. As for the bandits, you need to help Oak on normal for the life, kill them all in cruel for the skill point, and help Alira on merciless for more power charge awesomeness. For your gear, you primarily need to look for affixes such as spell damage, attack speed, accuracy, critical strike multiplier, life and evasion to make yourself more tanky, and of course enough elemental resistances so that you can be capped at 75% in merciless. And so besides the unique leveling items I recommended earlier in the guide, there is an additional 2 items I'd suggest grabbing if you want to take the build to the next level. The first one is the Lightning Coil armor. Not only does it grant life and a bit of evasion, but more importantly, it allows you to mitigate 30% of incoming physical damage as lightning damage, which then is mitigated by your lightning resistances, thus making you significantly tankier. This armor is amazing and it will make it much safer for you to do high level maps. The other item I will recommend is the Drillneck Quiver. With this quiver you will reach 100% chance to pierce on your barrage attack, which then translates to 100% increased damage for all projectiles fired including spark and ethereal knives, thus obviously adding tons of extra damage. Besides that, it grants a nice evasion, attack speed and life boost. Oh, and in case this wasn't obvious, you of course need to get yourself a Quill Rain, and the reason you want a Quill Rain is because of the insane attack speed it provides and the insane boost to projectile speed, which both benefits spark and ethereal knives. Try to get one with at least 90% increased projectile speed. But as I said early on in the guide, make sure to only use this bow once you get at least 70% crit chance with your power charges up through Deadly Infusion. The flask setup I recommend is 2 Divine Life Flasks of Staunching, 1 ample basalt flask of warding, an ample topaz flask of grounding, and a surgeon's quicksilver flask of adrenaline for that extra movement speed. And that's it guys, make sure to check the forum guide for more details and for future updates to the build. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them down in the comments section or in the forum post. If you liked the video and want to see more, subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching, and bros, do you even nerd?